Brendan Isaacson. You know, I'm glad to be able to stand here and talk to you guys today. Today I'm going to tell you about my stepfather, Alan Isaacson Jr. And, you know, just imagine that you're somewhere in life where you just kind of felt stuck. Imagine that you just graduated high school, you have no money for school, so you decide to join the military. And then once you get out of the military, you have a two-year-old son, and you're talking to a girl that already has a son with no father. This is my stepfather, Alan Isaacson Jr. Alan Isaacson was born June 18th, 1974. He was in Detroit, Michigan. He was raised in Redford, Michigan. He was raised by both his mother and father, who were divorced when he was only 5 years old. My father's stepfather treated him a lot different than his blood son. So when he was 13, he decided to move in with his father. Once he was living with his father, he realized how you should be able to raise a kid that's not your own blood. And he saw that through my grandpa, Alan Isaacson Sr. In his childhood, he grew up playing hockey and throughout Redford Township. He played baseball and soccer for the school, Redford Union High School. Once he was a junior, he decided to enlist in the Air Force. And he decided to enlist in the Air Force so he could get money for school using the GI Bill. After graduation into his adult years, he was stationed in Marquette, Michigan, where his first son, Anthony Stadler, was born. And then he was stationed in Europe and in multiple countries over the next 3.5 years. After serving his first enlistment, he decided to get out after 4 years with an honorable discharge. Upon returning home, he stumbled across my mom again, and I was about 5 years old. My father had left. They got married May 17th, 2003, and had my little sister February 25th, 2007. Following his dreams, he always wanted to find ways to make people laugh and make people happy. So therefore, he started doing comedy at Mark Wrigley's Comedy Club. And in 2014, he started to be a part of Cave Radio, which is a radio broadcasting company. His first show was called Big Al's Bad Advice. And then in 2016, he took the general manager position at Cave Radio. This gave him a chance to get his comedy out to the public, and now he enjoys showcasing local bands and supporting the local music scene. This served as his love for music, and he was able to sit around home and play guitar, you know, for us as I was growing up. Now, Al's influence on me. I was born Brendan Matthew Magro in Detroit, Michigan, August 20th, 1995. My biological father left when I was 4 years old. He left me on the side of the road in the middle of Detroit until my grandparents' neighbors saw me and took me home. From that moment, I didn't see him for another 12 years. When I was 5 years old, Al stepped into my life and did something not many other guys would have done for me. He claimed me as his own and treated me like I was his blood. He legally adopted me in 2004 when my biological father terminated his rights. And, you know, he bragged about me because when he got the adoption letter, was the same day my little sister was born, so he got two kids in one day.
Aww.
As I was a kid, you know, I played a lot of sports growing up. And eventually, he became my coach. And he was a lot harder on me than all the other kids, but, you know, it made me a better hockey player. He taught me some character. And then I also gained an interest in music, which I picked up the guitar when I was about 11 years old. Now I write my own music, perform for select people because I'm a little nervous when I sing. Some life lessons that my dad has taught me is nothing's gonna be just given to you. You need to go out and get what you need. Therefore, you know, I left for the Navy in January 2014 so I get money for school, the same thing that he did. I learned the power of being able to change people's mood, the ability to make people laugh and smile can change somebody's entire day. And most importantly, he taught me how to carry myself as a person and take responsibility for my actions and respect everybody the way that I would like to be respected and to always be humble. Now, I would not really be standing here today if it wasn't for him, because my life could have taken a completely different path if he wasn't there for me. Now, because at the start of my life I had nothing, but when he came into my life, he pushed me to follow my own dreams. Without him, I would have taken a completely different route and I would still be a Magro. But I'm more than proud to stand here to say that I'm an Isaacson, and I'll always try my best to make my dad proud and live up to the Isaacson name by following my dreams and trying to bring out the best in people around me and make them smile. Thank you, guys.